Ruslan gives up the argument here. The debate here, the conversation is now over, because he's saying, you know, my ideas, what I think you should do, it's not in the Bible. It's not there. This is just my idea. And at that point, it's like, later on in the video, Ruslan will say, let me tell you my heart in this. And on Gab yesterday, I said, Ruslan, with all due respect, you seem like a nice guy. You know, I'd like to hang out with you one day, probably, and all that kind of stuff. I probably enjoy myself. But I don't really care what your heart is in justice. And that's, I'm just keeping it 100. You know what I mean? I don't care one iota what your heart says we should do when it comes to justice. What I care about, and neither should you care about what my heart says. Like, that's not what we're after, because we know from the scripture that the heart is desperately wicked, right? We understand that. And I don't care what your heart says. You shouldn't care what my heart says. What we should both care about, especially if we're both professing Christ, Ruslan, is that, what does God say? What does God say? And I think that the temptation that you've given over yourself to is that God doesn't really say much on modern issues. He doesn't really say a lot that affects today. And I think that's a lie. I think that's untrue. You just don't like what he says about it, because God does talk about education. What does he say? What does he say? He says that educating the children is a responsibility of the parents. You don't like what that says. You don't like that, because you know, and this is where I think emotions are a double-edged sword, Ruslan. I think that your emotions are a double-edged sword, and not just you, all of ours are. Because we hear that from God, and we go, this is what we say. We say, God, that might be good for me, because I'm a Christian, and I'm going to raise my kids in the fear and admonition of the Lord and all that kind of stuff. But I have a neighbor over here, God. You might not have known this, but I got this neighbor over here who's a drunk, right? He's a drunk, and he doesn't care about his kids, and he doesn't raise his kids in the fear and admonition of the Lord. He doesn't do anything. All he does is lift up the beer to his mouth and drink. That's all he does. You might not have known that, God. And so when you wrote this scripture, you didn't take that into account. And so what we need to do, what my heart says, I want to care for those kids, is I want to tell the government to steal from everybody else in order to provide an education for that kid, because that's fair. Because that's fair. And you didn't address that in the Bible, God. You didn't address it. And so we're going to take matters into our own hands, and we're going to go and we're going to do that. And it sounds really good, because I have sympathy for that kid too, right? I have sympathy for that kid too. But the problem is that God does know about my neighbor who's a drunk. You know what I mean? Not only that, he knew about drunks and pagans and idolaters and all that stuff back when he told Israel that the responsibility for education is on the father. And that's it. And that's the end of it. And so God knew about that, and yet he still spoke on this topic, Ruslan, which you're saying he did not speak. He did speak on this topic. You just don't like what he said. You think it's incomplete. You think that you can do a better job in telling people who's responsible for educating the kids. And I'm here to tell you that that's a fantasy. In fact, I would say that you need to repent of that. You need to repent of that. So no, I don't want to work in the unbeliever's system. I want to change the system into a godly system. That's what I want. And I think every Christian should want this as well. How does that little kid get educated? Well, I'll tell you what, man. This is the hard work. This is the hard work that God specifically tells us what to do. He specifically tells us how to take care of this. And here's how you do it. You go and you make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe everything that Christ commanded. Not what men commanded, not what men imagined in their hearts and in their imaginations, what Christ commanded. Christ wrote the law of God. He wrote it. He wrote the law of God. And so that's what we teach people to obey. And if that requires that we change the system from a pagan system to a Christian system, then so be it. We do it God's way. We preach that gospel to that drunk. And we get involved in that drunk's life. And we tell the drunk, this is what the Lord says. This is what you should be doing. I'll help you, man. I'll help you with your kid. If you look, we're homeschooling anyway. You want to send your kid over here? We'll teach him as well. My church has a program. You know, whatever it is, that's how we do it. We don't need to steal from other people in order to accomplish this, Ruslan. You see, your mindset needs to change. You need to get yourself sold out to what the scripture says, and you gotta stop this, because we all have this in our hearts to some degree where we think we know better than God. We think we know better. Well, he couldn't have possibly have seen this modern context in advance. So we know we got to call someone by their gender pronouns. I mean, it's just hospitality, right? We always think we know better, man. And that's sin, man. That's the sin nature in us. You see, God does speak about these things. You just don't like what he has to say. And guess who needs to change? It's you. It's you. You know, I don't like sometimes what God has to say, man. Sometimes to me, you know what it comes across as? It comes across as a little bit harsh. But that's something I need to mortify in myself. Because if God's word comes across a little too harsh for me, I'm the one who needs to change.